Okay, today topic is about the principle of superposition. So as we have learned last time, I talked about the node and mesh analysis, right? And nodal analysis, right? Nodal analysis, and then mesh analysis. And so with these two method, we can solve any circuit. Okay. So, but if you have the current source, a lot of current source in the circuit, you should use nodal analysis, right? And if you have a lot of voltage source in the circuit, you should have the mesh analysis. Anyway, you can use both method for any circuit as well, or you can use both method for the circuit includes both current and voltage source. Okay, but it depends on the equation that you form, how complex the equation, and then you solve that equation. Okay. Also, I'm thinking about our quiz. Maybe I will quiz for the nodal analysis and mesh analysis maybe very soon. So please try to do the homework. Okay. Then today topic is the principle of superposition. And what is superposition? Superposition is another method that will help you to solve the electric circuit with many voltage and current source, right? So to do this, when you have n source or n voltage and current source, right, you can solve the circuit with one by one source, right? Solve the circuit with only one by one source. So we substitute as a source, right? We setting all but one, right? All but one source equal to zero. Equal to zero mean the voltage source equal to zero. It mean short circuit. We set the voltage source as short circuit. And then for the current source, to set the current source to zero, we just make it open, right? No current flow. So it is the open circuit. Okay. Then we solve that circuit one by one. And the answer is the solution of the sum of the solution of each, the solution of each circuit with one by one source, right? For example, we have VB1 and VB2. We can substitute VB2 as zero. This means short circuit here, right? And we solve for IB1. Then we solve the circuit with VB2 and we compute IB2, right? And the total current I will equal to IB1 plus IB2 is the sum together. We call this technique as superposition. Okay, it will help to solve the complex circuit and make the circuit more simple, right? With only one source, the circuit it will be more simple, right? And how to do this if you have voltage source and current source in the circuit, so you can substitute the voltage source to zero by short circuit. Then you solve this circuit, right? What you would like to know, for example, the current flow through R2 with the only IS in this case, right? We solve this circuit and then we substitute the current source by zero current, it means open circuit. Then we compute this circuit and we got IR2 with only VS, right? Then IR2 of this circuit, IR2 of the original circuit or this circuit, IR2, then is equal to IR2 with only IS plus IR2 with only VS, right? So we solve these two circuits instead of to solve this circuit, right? Okay, this is just the technique of superposition. Okay, and this is one example, right? And in this case, we have the circuit with voltage source and current source, right? This is 10 volt. And this is 2 ampere, right? R1 is 5 ohm, R2 is 2 ohm, R3 is 4 ohm, right? In this case. And then we just saw the circuit with only Vs. And then we saw the circuit with only Is. So substitute Is equal to 0. In this case, we substitute Vs equal to 0. And we saw for I1 and I2. Then the original I1 will be this is I1 with only Vs, and this I2 with only Vs. This is I1 with only Is. Here I2 with only Is. Later we can get I1 and I2 with this circuit, for example. So anywhere you can do the same thing, right? So for example, you would like to know the voltage across R3 in this case. So if you would like to know V across R3 in here, right? We just saw V across R3 with only Vs, right? Just saw this circuit. And then we saw V across R3 with only Is. Then the answer would be V across R3 with only Vs plus V across R3 with only Is, right? Then follow the rule that you solve the circuit with one by one source, okay? And this is another one example, right? If you have the circuit, right? So determine the voltage across the resistor R here, right? You like to know VR here of this circuit. So you can use nodal analysis or mesh analysis as well. Nodal analysis or mesh analysis, right? As well, right? But here we will use the superposition techniques to solve this circuit, right? And we have IB 12 ampere. We have VG 12 volt. RB is 1 ohm, right? And RG is 0.3 ohm. R is 0.23 ohm, right? So we just remove the current source and voltage source and so two circuit. Okay, so first we remove, we set the voltage as 0, right? 0 volt means we short circuit here. Then we solve for VR, right? IB is here and we solve for VR. This is will be VR with only IB, right? And then we remove IB, set IB to 0, right? Here IB is 0, it means open circuit. So we saw VR of this circuit. This is VR with only VG, right? And then VR total will be VR with only IB plus VR with only VG, right? Just solve for this value and this value and add it together. This will be the answer, right? The voltage across R. Get this. Here, first we solve for VR, right? Here, IB. Just take in this example, just take the many of you is coming now, okay. We just take this the KCL here, right? KCL at this node, right? So you will get the current inject to the node as negative, right? In this case, if you inject as negative, the flowing out mean positive, right? Flow out is positive. Or you can make the current flow into the node as positive sign, and then flow out is negative as well, right? Just use only one systematic method, right? If you The current flow inside is negative, flow out is positive. Okay, same thing. Or flow out equal to flow in. Okay, you can do that as well. So in this case, minus IB plus, what is the current flow to this branch? It will be V, right? This is VR, right? V, this voltage mean VR. So if you get this voltage, we get VR, right? VR, we are divided by RB, right? We are divided by RV plus VR. Here, in this notation, just mean VR with only I mean. Or here, I wrote down VR with only IB, right? Yeah, VR with only IB. Yeah, VR with only IB. Yes, same meaning, right? VR with only I. Okay, and we are with only I divided by RG, and we are with only the current source divided by this resistance equal to zero, right? Here, this is a KCL equation, and then we solve for VR because we know IB, we know the resistance of all resistor, right? Just substitute the value, so try to check this also, right? You just substitute the value and solve for VR, right? This value is here, right? Okay, we got VR with only current source is 1.38, right? And then we solve for VR with only VG, right? We remove the current source and then we solve for VR in this case. This is also, we can use KCL also. This is KCL, this is VR. And what is the current flow out, flowing out and flowing out here? This is VR divided by RB, right? Yeah. And this is VR minus VG, right? The voltage across RG is VR minus VG, right? Divided by RG, we get this current, and this current would be VR divided by R, right? And this notation is VR with only VG, right? VR with only voltage source. VR with only voltage source. VR with only voltage source, and we know RB, we know VG, RG, and R. Then we solve for VR with only voltage source. Then just substitute the value and then just rearrange the equation. We will get this VR with only voltage source, and we sum these two value together. This will be VR of this circuit, right? So this is the technique called superposition, right? It's not very difficult, right? It's a very useful techniques one, right? When we have different types of source, it's really very, very useful techniques. Okay, an equation about this the superposition technique. So you can try to make more familiar with this technique by solving your homework by superposition as well, right? You can use superposition with this circuit, with this circuit as well. You get just for practice, right? And you can check the answer that is equal to nodal analysis or mesh analysis or not. If you do it correctly, it should be come out with the same answer, right? Okay. Then maybe no question at this moment, but if you have question, you can send me the message later. Okay. So now we come to another topic. We call the one port network and equivalent circuit. Equivalent circuit means the circuit that equal to its equal characteristic to each other. For example, if I have the circuit, right? This with terminal A and B, maybe this is 3 ohm and this is 2 ohm. Maybe this circuit with only one resistor A and B with 5 ohm we call these two circuits are equivalent, right? It's equivalent because if we do anything with the terminal A and B, the circuit will respond the same thing, right? The same thing. Okay, for example. And for more complex, if we can find out the equivalent circuit, then we the equivalent circuit of this circuit, right? It will be very useful because we don't need to solve the whole circuit, right? If we just got the maybe this circuit can be substituted by the equivalent circuit, maybe only one source with one resistance, right? Equivalent, maybe V equivalent, for example. And this circuit will act to other circuit at its terminal with the same, right? With the same thing, right? So it's become more simple with a circuit, right? Okay, the very popular equivalent circuit, we have to tie to form the equivalent circuit of any complex circuit, right? The complex circuit we can form into two types of circuit we call the Thevenin equivalent circuit using Thevenin theorem and Norton equivalent circuit, Norton equivalent Norton theorem. And for Thevenin equivalent circuit, the complex circuit, any complex circuit can be substituted by one voltage source with one resistor, with one impedance. This is the Thevenin equivalent circuit. And this is the Norton equivalent circuit. For it means that any source can be, or active circuit, any active circuit can be substituted by one current source in parallel with one resistor, right? For Thevenin circuit, it's one voltage source in parallel with, in series, right? In series with one resistor. This is Norton. And Thevenin and Norton will be also equivalent circuit to each other, right? Because when you connect the load to Thevenin circuit, the voltage and current will be the same as we connect the load to Norton equivalent circuit in this. Okay, to determine the Norton and Thevenin equivalent circuit, right? First, we need to solve for these two values. So any complex circuit, for this may be complex circuit, then we can determine the voltage and resistance for Thevenin equivalent, right? How to get what is the R Thevenin or V Thevenin of this circuit, of any circuit, how to get it? If you can get these two values, you can substitute the circuit by only one single source and one resistance. Okay. And how to get the R Norton and I Norton of this circuit, right? From this circuit. So this is the topic that we will talk about. Okay. So how to get the equivalent resistance here, right? To compute the equivalent resistance of the circuit, okay, any network, right? First, we remove the load, right? We like, for example, we would like to get the equivalent circuit of this circuit. How to get the equivalent circuit of this circuit, right? So with this circuit, we can substitute the circuit into V Thevenin with one R Thevenin connect to the load RL, right? This terminal A and B here, A and B here. So if we change the value of RL, right? For example, this is maybe the value of RL is mean the load, right? Connect to this circuit. Maybe we change the value of RL and we recompute this circuit, right? We change RL and recompute this circuit. So we have to solve this circuit again and again. That if we substitute this this circuit into this circuit, right? We change the value of RL, it will be easier to solve for next time, right? For next time. So to do this, first we remove this terminal, right? We would like to get the equivalent circuit between port A and B, right? We remove RL first, we get this circuit, right? After we remove, we zero all independent voltage and current source, right? It means that the voltage source will substitute by zero and current source is substituted by zero also. So if the voltage source is there, we set it to short circuit, right? Short circuit with 0 volt, right? Short circuit. And if the current source is there, we substitute the current source by open circuit, right? Similar to the superposition technique. Okay, similar to the superposition technique. Okay, so in this case, the voltage source will be substituted by zero voltage. It's been short circuit, and then we just solve for the equivalent resistance of this circuit, right? We just parallel R1 and R2 together and sum to R3. Then this is the equivalent resistance of the circuit here. Okay, so for example, if we would like to get the equivalent resistance of this circuit, right? Look from A and B into this circuit. What is the Thevenin equivalent resistance? So we remove the current source. For current source, we make it zero. The zero current means it's open circuit, right? Just make it open. So no current flow at all, right? In this case, and then what we know is R1, R2, this is current here, right? R3, R4, R5, right? So we have got R1 is 20, R2 is 20, R3 is 10, R4 is 20, and R5 is 10, right? So just compute the total resistance, look from port A and B here, right? So we parallel R1 and R2 together, we'll get 10 ohm, right? We get 10 ohm. Add up together, we'll get 20 ohm. And parallel to R1, we get 10 ohm. So finally, we'll get the total resistance 20 ohm. This is the Thevenin equivalent circuit, right? When we substitute this circuit by Thevenin equivalent, it will be one voltage source with 20 ohm, right? At the terminal A and B here, right? When we connect to the other circuit or other element here, and this is V Thevenin. Okay, so now we know how to compute the R Thevenin, right? R equivalent, and then how to compute the Thevenin voltage. How to compute the Thevenin voltage? The Thevenin voltage can be computed by we just remove the connection here and we solve for this voltage of this circuit, right? With source, with current source, what is the voltage here? It will be the Thevenin voltage, right? We just solve the circuit by the techniques that we learned earlier. You can solve for VT using any technique. For example, nodal analysis or mesh analysis. Or we may use superposition analysis. Okay, so any techniques we solve for VT, then we will get Thevenin equivalent circuit. Yeah. Okay, let's see this example, right? To get the Thevenin equivalent resistance of this circuit. So to get the Thevenin equivalent of this circuit, we substitute current source by 0 ampere, it means open circuit, and substitute voltage by 0 voltage, it means short circuit, right? So we get this circuit to solve. Okay, it will be R1 parallel R2 plus RT and parallel with R4, right? And in this case, R1 is 2, R2 is 2, R3 is 1, and R4 is 2, it means 2 is, so it's 1 ohm here, right? 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 parallel with 2, so it's 1 ohm here, right? So, and then when we would like to get the V Thevenin, it means voltage in between A and B here, right? We remove RL, no RL, and then we solve for the voltage of this node, right? It will be VT, right? Just solve for VT here of this circuit, okay? So you can use node mesh or superposition here. And then when you have got Thevenin equivalent resistance, it will be the same as Norton equivalent resistance. So this value RT and RN are the same, right? This value are same. Okay. Then how to compute Thevenin voltage? So I have I told you before, right? It's the voltage of that two terminal, right? One chat. Yes, I am recording, but I use the other program, okay. okay, Thevenin voltage, we can compute it by any technique, right? To show that the voltage in between two terminal, right? Just in between two terminal, okay. I will show you by example, right? Here, okay, with this circuit, so how to get the voltage of these two terminal? It means this voltage right here, VA, so VB, this is V and this is VA right here, VA, and VB is the same as ground, right? This is zero voltage, right? Zero volt, and this is V, we use notation as V. Maybe earlier when we use nodal analysis, maybe we call this V1, this is V2 for example, but anyway we call this node, the voltage of the node V, and VA here is also 5, right? V and here is VA here, so look, just solve for VA, then you got VOC, right? And this is V Thevenin of this circuit. So apply KCL at the two node. Yeah, the two node mean this two node, right? This two node, this node, and this node, right? So KCL of this node. What happened to KCL of this node? So we have got V. This is 12 volt, and this is 1 ohm, right? 1 ohm, and this is 10 ohm. This is 10 ohm and this is 20 ohm here. 20 ohm, this 1 ohm. So KCL, just follow the process. Just follow the process, right? The current flow, right? In this case, the current flow in and out. So I look to this. You can use any notation. Okay, any notation, but maybe flow in positive and flow out negative, right? And flow out here is negative, right? The node is here, right? So we can form the equation V minus V, right? V minus V divided by R1 here. This is the current flow through R1, and the current flow through R2 is V minus 0, right? V divided by R2. V divided by R2 is here, right? And then V minus VA, right? V minus VA divided by R3 here, equal to 0 here. This is the node 1, right? And then for this node, V minus VA, okay, V minus VA flowing in is positive. The flowing in is V minus VA, right? And flowing out is negative, minus VA divided by R4 here, yeah. Okay. So if we use different notation, so I put the current flow here as positive, flowing out here as positive here, right? Positive, positive like this. So it will be VA minus V, right? VA minus V divided by R3 plus here VA divided by VA divided by R4 equal to 0. So this equation and this equation are same. So you can use any notation, right? Just be careful, flowing in positive will be used for all current, but for flowing out, if you use flowing out to be positive current, you need to use for all current, for all notation, right? In this case, flowing out, we have to use VA minus V, right? The current will flow in this direction. But if you use V minus VA, the current flow in this direction, right? Yeah, okay. I think you can follow. Maybe you try to just make a short note again, right? After class. Okay, so this is the note 2 equation. So for this 2 term, we know we just can solve for VA, right? Because we know, what we know is, we know V, right? V is 12 volt, we know V. We know R1, R2, R3. And we know R3 and R4. So we have 2 equation, right? 2 equation. So we arrange these 2 equation and solve it, okay. And in this example, the order solved by the metric method, right? Metric method. Just arrange the equation, okay. So I will show you some here the equation become V is 12, right? 12, R is 1, R2 is 10, R3 is 10, right? And this is R3 is 10, this is 10. So in this case, if I have to solve this equation, I will multiply 10 to this equation. Multiply 10. So I will get 120 minus 10V, right? And then minus V. Minus V minus VA equal to 0 here, right? And then V will be minus 12V minus 20V. So this is minus 12V and VA plus VA, right? Plus VA 120. Plus 120 equal to 0. Then we can say 12V minus VA equal to 120, right? Here is equation 1. And for this equation, I will multiply 20, right? Multiply 20 to this equation. I will get 2V minus 2VA, right? And then minus VA equal to 0. In this case, it will be, right? 2V okay, 2 and then VA 2V minus 3VA, right? Minus 3VA equal to 0. This is equation 2. So this is 2 equation to solve, right? I think it's similar to this equation. This equation. These 2 equation, these 2, this equation in metric form is mean that 1.2 into V minus 0.1 into VA is equal to 12, right? So this is 1.2 into V minus 0.1 into VA equal to 12, and minus 0.1 minus 0.1 V, right, plus 0.15 VA equal to 0. This is another the 2 equation in 2 form, right? I think these are the same, right? Equation 1 and equation 1 is the same equation, right? You just divide that by 10 into this equation, and this equation you divide this equation by maybe 20, right? Divided by 20 to the equation, you get this equation, right? So these two this set of equation are the same, right? And then we solve for V and VA, you get VA here, right? VA, VA will be VOC, VA will be 7.059 volt, and it will be the Thevenin equivalent, right? Yeah, because VA minus VB, VB is zero, right? Yeah, this is Thevenin equivalent. You get this value here, 7.059 volt for V Thevenin. And R Thevenin, if you would like to solve for R Thevenin, you just set this voltage zero, right? So and so for total R equivalent, you will get R Thevenin. So it's not very difficult to solve for Thevenin and Norton equivalent. It depends on how complex of this circuit, right? So if the circuit is easy, it's not difficult to find out Thevenin equivalent. So I will not give you a very complex circuit. I just would like you to know the concept, right? Just the concept, how to compute the Thevenin equivalent and Norton equivalent circuit. Just only that objective that I will give to you. Okay, let's see another one example. So we have this circuit here, right? So for this circuit. So then first, to solve the Thevenin equivalent right here of this circuit, right, the terminal between A and B. Okay, first we solve for RT, so the equivalent resistance. So the voltage source will be substituted by short circuit, and the current source will be substituted by open circuit. So we have only two resistance connect in parallel, and R1 is 4, R2 is 12. These two resistance parallel to each other, we got 3 ohm, right, as equivalent resistance here. The equivalent resistance, it will be 3 ohm here, right? And to solve for the voltage across A and B, right, without R3, we solve for voltage of this circuit here, right, solve for here. So what we can do, we take KCL at this node, KCL to this node, right? KCL this node. So the current flowing in will be V minus, this will be VA, right? This is VA minus VA divided by R1, right? And this is I, right? Flowing at this I. And the current flow here, maybe we use flowing out notation. If we use flow out notation, the current would be in negative, right? VA divided by R2. So total current would be V minus VA divided by R1 plus I, right? Plus I and minus VA minus divided by R2 here, right? We can substitute V. We can substitute V. 24 minus VA divided by R1 is 4 plus I is 3 M, and then minus VA divided by R2. VA divided by R2 is 12 equal to 0. Just solve for VA, right? So VA would be VOC, right? And then it would be Thevenin voltage, equivalent voltage, right? Then we got VA at 20 volt. So the equivalent circuit of this circuit will be this circuit, right? The voltage is 27 volt, and the resistance is 3 ohm here. Okay. So any circuit connect to this circuit will have the same character with connect to this circuit. So this circuit are equivalent, these two circuit are equivalent. So if we connect the resistance 6 ohm to this circuit, so we can solve for the current I very easy. So it will be the voltage divided by these two resistance in series, right, in series together. So we get 3 ampere as the answer. Okay, so if you solve this circuit, you will get this is 3 ampere also, but you don't need to solve that. If you know the equivalent circuit, we can use equivalent circuit, right? Okay, and this is the technique called Thevenin equivalent circuit, right? And you can transform Thevenin to Norton equivalent circuit also. So how to compute the Norton equivalent circuit? If you have got the Thevenin circuit, you can get the Norton equivalent circuit directly. Norton equivalent circuit can obtain by R Norton is R Thevenin. You can use the same technique to solve for RN. RN and RT will be solved by the same method, right? With this method, right? To make this zero and this zero, then you check, you get RT, it will be RN also. Then the current in Norton, you can solve by you short the circuit here. When we short the circuit here, we get ISC. ISC is I short circuit. I short circuit and I Norton are the same because the current will flow this way. So if you short the circuit and you got the value of current, it will be the Norton circuit, Norton current source, right? Norton current source here. Just short the circuit and if you would like to compute the short circuit current between A and B, for example, with this example, you just can short the circuit here, right? And compute the current here. You get the same thing, right? Because it's equivalent. Therefore, I short circuit or I Norton equal to V Thevenin divided by R Thevenin, right? So I Norton will be equal to V Thevenin divided by R Thevenin. So after you obtain the Thevenin equivalent circuit, you will obtain Norton equivalent circuit directly, right? Because you get the current of Norton equivalent circuit. So I Norton is V Thevenin divided by R Thevenin, and R Norton will be R Thevenin, right? So if you get the Thevenin equivalent circuit, you will get Norton equivalent circuit directly here. Yeah. Okay. Okay, let's see this example. Okay. For this circuit, so we have V is 6 volt, right? 6 volt. I is 2 ampere. R1 is 6 ohm. R2 is 3 ohm. And R3 is 2 ohm. So how to get the equivalent circuit? So in this case, we have to solve for Norton current. So solve for Norton current mean we Norton equivalent resistance and Norton current, right? For equivalent resistance, we look into this circuit, right, by make this voltage zero and make this current zero. Okay, so you get this circuit, right? This circuit will be R1 in parallel with R2, right, and sum to R3, right? This mean 6 parallel with 3 ohm and sum with 2 ohm, right? We get 4 ohm here, right? I think you can sum this resistance together, right? So try to check it, right? This will be 6 by 3 and 6 plus 3 and plus 2, maybe like this. Then to get the Norton current, it means we short this circuit, right? We short this circuit, and so for ISC is to be I Norton. So if you like to get the Thevenin voltage, this is VT. You open this circuit and solve for VT, you get Thevenin voltage. You short this circuit, you solve for ISC, you get is mean I Norton here, right? So in this case, we short this circuit and solve for this current here. Okay. Then how to get this current? In this case, we apply KCL at node 1 and 2, right? Apply KCL here and KCL here, right? This current we don't know. We don't know this current. So we don't know this current. And then for node 1 is I, right? I minus V1 divided by R1, right? And then minus I, so the current I. And next is for node 2, current I minus V2 divided by R2, V2 divided by R2, minus V2 divided by R3, right? So this row divided by R3 here. So we have node 1 and node 2 equation, but we have too many unknown, right? Because we know I, right? I, R1, we know R2 and R3, but we don't know V1 and V2 and I. So this is three unknown in two equation. So it's we cannot solve these two equation, but what we know is the relation between V1 and V2, because V1 and V2 we differ to each other by V, right? Here so V1 would be V2 minus V here. V1 is V2 minus V, because V2 minus V1 equal to V, right? V2 minus V1 equal to V, because V is, on the other hand, V because positive is near, V equal to V2 minus V1, right? Or we can say that V1 equal to V2 minus V here. Then we substitute V1 by V2 minus V. Then after that, we will get two unknown, right? With these two unknown, then we solve the circuit for V. Then after we get V2, we will get the current ISC here, right? I and V2 in this case. Then I will try to substitute for you, right? I is 2 ampere. So 2 ampere minus V2 minus V. V is 6 volt divided by R1 is 6 ohm, right? Minus I equal to 0. So we rearrange this. We can rearrange this equation, and this another equation is I minus V2 divided by R2. What is R2? R2 is 3 ohm minus V2 divided by R3. R3 is 2 ohm equal to 0. Just rearrange these two equations. Okay, and this in this case, this example arranged the equation with the variable, right? Not in number. I usually do this kind of problem by substitute the number first, right? And it's up to you. And so if I need to solve these two equation, what I do is, so I will multiply 6 to the first equation. I get 6 multiplied to 2 is 12, minus V2 minus 6 and minus 6i equal to 0, and then I will get minus V2 plus together, it should be 18, right? And then minus 6i minus then 18 equal to 0. Or we can write out as V2 plus 6i equal to 18. So maybe this is one equation. V2 plus 6i. This is first equation. And then another equation, I will multiply 6 also, right? I will get 6i minus 2V2 minus 3V 2 equal to 0. So this will be 5, right? 5 V2 minus 6I equal to 0. This is the second equation. Then I will solve these two equations for I and V2. I hope that we will get this value after we solve this equation. So it's up to you what to solve. This is just to solve the equation. So it depends on the technique of each other. So I'm not serious with that technique, okay? But just do it correctly. It's okay. It's fine, right? And then now you get I and V2. Then after we get V2, you can calculate ISC really easy, right? ISC will be V2 divided by R3. We get 1.5 ampere. So the Norton equivalent circuit will be 1.5 ampere in parallel with Norton resistance equivalent here, right? 4 ohm, right? We compute it as 4 ohm. Here is the Norton equivalent circuit. So we can get a Thevenin and Norton. We can transform both Thevenin and Norton together. And what is the Thevenin voltage of this this circuit? We can solve V Thevenin from this circuit also, or we can solve V Thevenin of this circuit. And what is the voltage across A and B? It means there is only 1.5 amp 4 through 4 ohm, right, in this circuit. So the voltage here is 1.5 multiplied with 4. This will be 6 volt, right? The Norton is 6 volt. If you transform this circuit to Norton, it will be plus minus, and this is 6 volt with 4 ohm, right, for terminal A and B, and this is Thevenin circuit, right? So Thevenin and Norton circuit can be transformed to each other. Similarly, for this circuit, if you would like to show the Norton equivalent, so what is Norton Norton short circuit current? So we just short this circuit, right? It will be 27 divided by 3. It will be 27 divided by 3 is be 9 ampere, right? In parallel with 3 ohm here. This is A and B. This is Norton circuit of this circuit, right? So you can get Thevenin and Norton. When you have got one of them, you can get another one really easy, right? So for Thevenin and Norton theorem, we can use this for source transformation, because the source, usually the source will have the non-ideal source will have the voltage and resistance, internal resistance. You can transform Thevenin and Norton to each other. Okay, VT is RT into IN, right? Or here I Norton is VT divided by RT, right? And this is RT and RN are equal to each other. Yeah, this we call source transformation, and it's useful to solve the circuit with many non-ideal source. For example, in this case, we can change this term into this term, right? We change the voltage into current source, and similarly, this is a Thevenin form, right? We change it to current source also, right? After that, we will have only current source in the circuit, and it will be easy to solve by nodal analysis. For example, after you transform the circuit, you can solve it by nodal analysis very easy in this case, right? Okay. I will skip these topics. Now, if you're interested, you can go through this circuit, right? This is the experimental determination of Thevenin and Norton equivalent. So if we have unknown network, we measure the property of the network, right? We just measure the property of the network, and you can After that, this network can be calculated to have the Thevenin or Norton equivalent circuit also. Okay. Okay, and this is the homework for this part, and maybe I think this is homework 3, right? Homework number 3. So many homework, but I suggest you try to do it maybe step by step, right? Do not so worry. So I will give you maybe this homework maybe 1 week or so, right? So this homework will be due date on, you get the due date on, so next Friday is holiday, right? And next Monday also holiday, so we face so many holiday. So maybe I give you until 7th of Jan, right? 7th of Jan, too far, I don't know, but 7th of Jan, I think this homework, right? But submit to the e-learning channel. So we have some break, and then after that we talk about the makeup class. It's very important. We have four cancel class, right? We face 4 holiday. Okay, 4 or 5 holiday, I don't know. Okay, I will stop my record here.